name is Matt Perry, Technical Product Manager of Renewable Energy Products at Campbell Scientific. I'm here today to replace my old CS240 back of module temperature sensor with the new CS241 without replacing the home run cable, which in many instances is hundreds of feet in length. I'm going to use the M12 field connector kit, which comes with an M12 connector, a screwdriver, and an instruction sheet that shows how to prepare the CS240 cable and assemble the M12 connector. First, after powering off my data logger, I'm going to cut the cable off of the end of the CS240 temperature sensor. I'm not going to try to remove the temperature sensor from the back of the module because in many cases this could damage the back sheet of the module. After I cut the cable, I'm going to insert the M12 connector onto the cable and then prepare it for assembly. Next, I'm going to trim the cable. I'm going to cut 20 millimeters or 3/4 inch of the black insulation off of the cable. Then I'm going to trim 5 millimeters or about 3/16 of an inch of the insulation from the wires. Trimming the jacket and insulation, you'll see the cable is made of 6 wires. 2 red, 2 white, 2 black. There's also some filler and a shield. We're going to cut the shield and the filler off. Next, we'll insert each wire into the connector. First, I'll reference the key. This tells us the pin orientation of the wires. If we look at the connector here, here's the key. That tells us we've got pin 1 and 2 for red, pins 3 and 4 for white, 5 and 6 for the black wires. Okay, now we're ready to install the CS241 sensor on our retrofitted CS240 cable. Okay, and that's it. I hope you enjoyed the demonstration. Please visit www.campbellsci.com for more information.